In the last session, we discussed about the process of primary sales, preparation, visiting the project, promotion, putting it on your social media, calling your clients, marketing tools, WhatsApp, social media, prospecting, looking for clients, meeting or viewings with the clients in the developer's office, give some time to the client to feel comfortable with the environment, and how to take the client from from the presentation and negotiation to the closing level, expression of interest, booking, contract and SPA between the client and the developer, eligibility for commission, which needs down payment and SPA to be signed, and after the sell services, which includes getting referrals, renting out for the client, after sell services, like whenever the client needs any kind of services, communications with the developer, if there is some delay in the payments in between, reselling the unit, snagging, handover, reselling, renting it out. So this is how expression of interest looks like. This is a standard format of AMAR expression of interests, which includes the details of the client, what kind of project is he interested in. So this way client informs the developer that I am interested in so and so project. Usually we are getting expression of interest on the projects which are having more demand, especially these days, townhouses and villas. You need to provide an expression of interest. You need to get a check to support the expression of interest of the client. And usually, almost always, the check that the client puts will be totally refundable. This is how AMAR offer to purchase looks like. We can say in some developers' offices, they call it reservation form. The payment plan, price, details of the property, details of the client, everything is mentioned over there. Okay. This is when, generating this, if you want to make any changes in the payment, in the structure of the payment, this is what you can apply. You can request the salesperson to do. For example, there is a 5% down payment or there is a 10% down payment and you know that you will be eligible to take the commission after 20% and your client is okay to pay 20%, so you need to explain to the client that, see, basically you have the option to pay 10% now, 10% after 1 month, or if you don't want to come again, if you don't want to issue another check, or if you don't want to go ahead and make another payment, you can make the 20% down payment now. And this, once it is clear and understood for the client, then you can inform the salesperson to generate the offer to purchase with 20% down payment. So details of the unit, details of the client is there, and this is the only place that you will sign as an agent. I'm talking about AMAR expression of interest. You don't sign on the SPA, you don't sign on any other documents. The only place that you need to make sure that your company name and your name is mentioned is here. On the third page, offer is accepted by the management of AMAR. If there has been some changes, some small changes, and it is acceptable, then the developer will generate a SPA, sales and purchase agreement, between the client and the developer. Depending on the project, it can be 10 pages, 20 pages, 30 pages, 40 pages. These days, usually SPAs are like 10, 15 pages. They are more short, they are more brief. Back in the days, SPAs were booklets. So this is the first page of the SPA. So if you look at the old SPAs of AMAR, first page is the details of the property or details of the client, and second page is the payment plan. But over the past few years in AMAR SPA, the details of the client, details of the unit, and the payment plan, everything comes on the first, on the same page. And even if there is a DLD waiver or if there is any kind of incentives in terms of the land registration fees, it also will come on the first page. So this is how AMAR SPAs look like. OTP, SPA.
What's the difference between all three?
Expression of interest is when you the client informs AMAR that I'm interested in so-and-so project. Like, for example, St. Regis is not launched yet. If before the launch of St. Regis, for example, I am interested. This is my expression of interest. This is my passport copy. And to support my expression of interest, I will provide a check. which will be approximately 10% of the value. Case by case, project by project, developer by developer, it will be different. So to support your expression of interest, the client will provide a check, which usually, almost always, is refundable. So when it will be refundable, when the project details come, you have the layout, you have the exact price, you have the exact payment plan, at that time the client has the option to say yes, go ahead, or no, thank you very much, give me my check back. Okay, so this is expression of interest. Once that is done, if the client likes the unit and wants to go ahead, at the time of booking you generate an OTP. The salesperson, developer salesperson, generates an OTP, offer to purchase, which in Amar looks like this. This is a reservation agreement. This is a booking. Okay, so this will be signed by the client and by the agent. Details of the property, details of the unit, payment plan, everything will be mentioned there. So once this offer to purchase is signed and the down payment is made, then developer Amar will be able to generate a sales and purchase agreement. So this is the contract between Amar and the client. Once the SPA is signed, then the check will not be refundable. This is your first contract, yeah.
Do we as relators receive any contract?
Any document, every document that is generated as an agent, it's your duty, it's your job to take a picture, to keep a copy. Come again? When you are providing expression of interest, you don't have the exact prices, usually, right? You know that you are expecting 3 bedrooms in Damak Lagoons to be starting from 1.4 million, for example. So you provide an expression of interest, and to support it, you will provide a check of 140,000 to say that, okay, I'm ready to pay 10% of the purchase price as a down payment. Okay. Then the project will be launched. Now you will have the exact price and the exact payment plan and the exact floor plan and master plan. When the project is launched, it means it's already registered. When it's already registered, it means the exact price, payment plan, contents of the contract, everything is there. At that time, the price may differ, of course, because that was your expecting price. 1.4 was your 1.45, 1.4, whatever it is, was your expecting price. But now that it is launched, it is released, price may be different, maybe 1.5, maybe 1.4, maybe more, maybe less. Yes. So once the price comes, then the client has the option to say, yes, I want to go ahead, or no, thank you very much, give me my check back. Mm-hmm. Okay, but once the offer to purchase is signed and accepted by the developer, then the same thing will be SPA. Yes. Same contract. Yeah.
And how does it work with international clients?
With international clients, everything will be signed electronically except the SPA. SPA has to be signed originally. So you have to get it couriered to the client.
Yeah, we did it once with
one. International client. Let's say you have a client out of country. Okay. You will go to Amar on behalf of the client, you will choose the unit, the client choose the unit, this is the unit, this is the price, this is the payment plan, all is good, right? So you will receive the client's passport copy. With the client's passport copy, you will go to your Amar One app. My Amar app, sorry. Amar One is for the owners. For the agents, you go to My Amar app with your username and password of Amar. As a registered agent of Amar, you will log into the app. When you log into the app, you will be able to book the unit. Do you guys know how to book a unit on my Amar app?
We know how to issue sales offer.
Actually, I wanted to have a separate session for all the apps and everything, but maybe we can.
Before signing SPA, there is a chance for the client to back off, right?
Hmm?
Before signing SPA, a client can back off from his agreement or like...
Yes.
Did you receive the offer to purchase?
Yes.
Even at the 2 years in OT.
So signed electronically and then there's a dispute. Where it will... Well, in which country it will... The dispute will be...
Come again?
If they sign electronically, e-signature, both parties, you one UAE and one in Germany. Dispute where it will be resolved.
The OTP is just a reservation. It doesn't mean anything. It's not a legal binding contract. That's what I'm saying. You want to close the deal. The deal is closed when SPA is signed, down payment is made. And you need to make sure that this happens as soon as possible. Client is interested, OTP is signed, everything is okay, try to generate the SPA, try to get the SPA as soon as possible and get it signed as soon as possible. Because unless